Hey there, how was doing? This is Kali from Techfanciers. So in this video we will be taking a look at latest official AOSP extender version 6.5. Technically this is not a latest because that's my device Oreo vendor supports this, not the newer one which is the 6.6. Hope both the build have the same features and specifications. You can try this in your device. Here I am using ASUS Zenfone Lite L1. We'll make this quick and clear as we already spoke and has a lot on AEX before and about Android PIE GSIs. So here it is, in-depth look, episode number 22. This video only explains about the performance, battery backup, stability and finally my opinion. Regarding the features, I would suggest you guys to watch the video in the card or I button which appears now. Also consider taking a look at previous PIE in-depth look videos as the video might be the last PIE as we are moving towards Q. Content starts here. The performance. It's great while comparing to some other GSI like Havoc OS or official beta Zen UI, it works flawlessly most of the time. I can say best in the device. I don't know, I'm fear I might wrong as I'm coming straight from a buggy Zen UI beta. So it's better than that, period. Battery backup. It's good, not the best like stable official Oreo builds, but also it's not the worst. It gives most of the time around 4.5 hours to 5 hours of SOT of moderate use like listening music, watching YouTube, and I noticed that the app which we install is really matters and have in direct connection with the battery backup. So having a minimal app installation will or may increase the battery backup and give some extra alive minutes. Overall it's good. Stability. It's the main part when it comes to custom ROM or GSI in my opinion. It's more stable while comparing to Zen UI PIE or AOSP. It doesn't crash most of the time. I have been using this GSI for some weeks now. It's totally fine. Apps are working, not crashing like Zen PIE. I don't know why I am comparing this always with the Zen PIE. Anyway, the stability wise, all day-to-day apps are working fine. Doing its work well. I have no issues, especially the Lightroom apps working very good. Here comes the end, my opinion. Well, my opinion might be differs from yours, but you guys have been watching this series from past few months and when you try the same you might feel the same which I spoke on those videos. If yes, then my opinion will fit for you. Nonetheless, I was suggesting you guys to go with the .OS 3.0 GSI for quite some time as that have the inbuilt G apps and the features on the stability that was really great. But I have changed it. This is the best GSI out there with good stability. I have been complaining about the no sound while calling issue for most of the GSI. Well, in this I didn't face anything. I would say the reason might be that you can use the low-end open G apps like Pico, and don't installing the Google app will definitely improve the performance lot and avoids the tons of crashes and logs. Well, one word, if you are the one out there who looks for stock Android with customization need for long run, then I would highly suggest you to go with AEX. It offers features, stability and less bugs. So that's what about this video. Hereafter we will get into Android 10. I also have provided the poll in the community. I have received 40 plus votes. The high is in AOSPQ. We'll try it soon and also we'll be uploading some of the customization things and ways to improve the performance in low-end devices after the GSI. So you guys might like them. Keep in touch with us. Lot is waiting. Thank you for watching. Code Moto.